Hello, I'm Tristan. When I spec'd out my current machine down there, I knew that I wanted to go with a Ryzen 5900X. It's a beast of a CPU. It's got 12 cores and 24 threads. I mean, I don't even have fingers or toes to show that many threads. But whilst I was sure about the CPU, I wasn't so sure about how to cool it. After all, a beast of a CPU needs an awesome cooler, right? So I immediately went looking online for liquid coolers. However, since I was new to liquid cooling and my case, the Corsair Carbide 88R, doesn't support custom liquid cooling setups, I naturally looked at all-in-one liquid coolers instead. These appealed to me because they would fit inside my micro ATX case, but there's two downsides. I would lose one or two chassis fans, and many budget all-in-one coolers don't actually have great reviews. I mean, they generally have good reviews if you quickly look on Amazon, but if you dig deeper, some people complain that they leak after a few years, plus their actual cooling performance wasn't that great. To get a genuinely good liquid cooler that was durable and had awesome cooling performance would have been really, really expensive. As a result, I started considering air coolers. I already knew that Noctua products were the bee's knees. I'm so cool. So I went on their website. I started looking for coolers which were compatible with my micro ATX case, and as expected, many of the best coolers were not compatible. Yay. But there did seem to be some good options at least, which I then cross-referenced with Noctua's standardized performance ratings. Yes, I know that these could be biased, but so I also cross-referenced everything with independent reviews elsewhere, of course. But from the ratings, it was clear that the Noctua NH-C14S cooler was probably my best option. It had pretty good cooling performance, and of course it actually fit inside my case, my really small case, which was a bonus. I'm really glad that I purchased this particular cooler. It's brilliant. I mean, it feels really robust when I was installing it, and it's quite straightforward to install too, which is always nice. It also keeps my temperatures quite low. With Chrome, Photoshop, and a few other programs open, the CPU is probably around 40 to 45 degrees Celsius with 22 degrees Celsius ambient temperatures. If I then run Prime 95, I then hit 70 degrees Celsius after a few minutes, which then tops out around 75 to 80 degrees when running for a longer amount of time. And that's pretty good, to be honest. Naturally then, when I cancel the test, CPU temps drop pretty quickly. In short, I love this Noctua air cooler. It's brilliant. And the fact that it fits inside my small case and it outperforms many all-in-one liquid coolers is quite awesome. And that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button, which will tell YouTube that more people should see this video. Please also don't forget to subscribe and click the little bell icon, which will notify you when I release new videos. Thank you.